Good afternoon to all of you. Today we are going to start with a practical of power electronics subject. We are going to simulate that, and the simulation software which we are going to use is power sim. In short, it's PSIM. So you can see the monitor screen of my laptop. The software is this PSIM, and we are using the version 12.0.3. There are different versions available, and this software is freely available. So once you open this, this kind of window will come. So what we have to do initially, we have to choose, we have to take new file. So as we will take the new file, this kind of window will appear. After that, the practical which we have to perform, we have to simulate the component of that on this sheet. Suppose I want to execute single phase half wave control rectifier. So if we see the circuit diagram of single phase half wave control rectifier, then this is the circuit diagram of that. So we will be required with source, we will be required with step down transformer, then we will be required with probe, voltage probe, and two SCR, two diode. It's a half wave control rectifier. Then two gate circuit, which is going to produce the pulse. Then current probe. Then it's a resistive load, so we'll be required a resistance. And again a voltage probe to measure the output voltage, to see the output voltage waveform. Now, to execute this on power sim, I'm going to take different component as I shown you in the figure. So I will call the library first so that I can directly take all the components from there. So first of all, I'll require with the source. So source, it's a voltage source. So directly I have taken, some of the functions are already given in the downside, so we can directly choose from here. Then I will take thyristor. So to take thyristor, here is the thyristor. I will drag it and I can drop, but in the circuit diagram it is vertical, so I will right click on that, then again I will right click, and then again I will right click. So I want the status in this way, so after right clicking it will change 90 degree, and once the way we want, when once we get that, we will click over there. So it's a half wave control rectifier. I'll be required with two thyristors and two diodes. It is in bridge form, so two diodes we will be required. There will be required diode. Then I will require with a resistor. So I will drag it and I will drop. Over here. Now, to make a connection between these component, what I have to do, here is a wire. So I will choose this wire and I will make the connection between the different components. So in this way, we have to make the connections. After doing this, after joining these all components, right now I'm joining the thyristor and diodes only, and also I'm going to join source with this one. So what I am going to do, I will drag it upside again. I will choose this and I will join. In this fashion. Now what I am going to do is I am going to take gate pulse. So this is the gate. I will drag it and I will drop over here. Two SCRs are there, so I will require with the two gate circuits in this fashion. I will join these two in this way. In this way. So this is again it getting short over here. So what I'm going to do, I will take this gate circuit inside. Now again I will take this wire, and with the help of this wire I will join this. After this I will take probe, one for current, measuring the output current, and another one is for measuring the voltage, for getting it, for seeing the waveform of current and voltage. So here it's probe. So if you see, this is current probe. I will drag it and connect it across the output resistance. Then I will take a voltage probe. I will drag it and I'll drop over here. Again, I will take pencil and I will join in this fashion. So if I'll join this, in this way. Now the most important thing in this circuit is, once you have done the connection in this fashion, still you won't get the output. So we have to set the parameters of each of these components, which is very important. Therefore I'll start with voltage source. This voltage source which we are using over here is having the name VS. So peak amplitude should be 230 and frequency is 50 hertz. Now if I want that these parameters should be displayed across that source, so I'll just click over here. Once I'll click on the display, so it will, the readings will come across this. So the source will have the voltage of 230 volts and 50 hertz supply, and the name I had given to this source is VS. In the same way, thyristor, this thyristor, name of this thyristor is, I want to display thyristor name as T1. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select display T1, then I will display T2, then D1 diode, that should be display over there across the diode, and D2. That should be display over there, D2. Now same we will change the setting for gate circuit across T1 and gate circuit which is connected across T2. So for gate circuit, the frequency that we have to set is 50, and number of points will be 2. I want to trigger at 30 degree, therefore T1 will be switching point will 30 to 180 degree, and if I want that this should come, this should display over there, so I will tick on the display. Now second thyristor is T2, so name G2, frequency is 50, number of point is 2. The first thyristor was triggered at 30 to 180 degree, so we'll get the output for 30 to 180 degree. So second thyristor output will start at 180 plus 30, that means 210, and second waveform will be, second half cycle will be from 210 to 360 degree. So this we have to set. Once we will see the output, we will get it, we'll get to know what we are doing. After that, diode we have set, those things we have already set. Now value of resistor, so the value of resistor should be 10 ohm and current flag should be 0 and voltage flag should be 1. So if I want that 10 ohm should display over there, so I will click on the display button. Here it is, ILDC, so that it is display, it will I'll get to know that it is going to show the output current. In the same way, VLDC, so that I'll get to know that it is showing the output voltage. In this way it is going to show the different output for current and voltage. Now what we are going to do is, to synchronize these all, we are going to take one more element, that is simulation control, and I'm going to put it over here so that this thing should be happen at a time and there should be a synchronization between each. Our circuit is ready. The name of the circuit is half wave single phase half controlled bridge rectifier. So we are supposed to save this. Now I'm saving this in desktop. I'll take a folder PE, and in that I will put the name as half wave control rectifier HWCR. So this got saved over there. Now how to simulate it, how to run this? So go in simulate and run it. It will show some warning, just neglect that. Then such kind of window will come over there. After that, click on add all. Once we'll click on add all, if we see OK, so such kind of output we are getting. If we, I want to see each output, current output and voltage output separately, then in that case, what I have to do is, I'll simulate it and during simulation, I will choose one component at a one parameter at a time. Means now I have selected ILDC, so it will show the current voltage, current waveform. So current for resistive load half control rectifier is this, in this way we know this, so that is correct. Now second is I want to see the voltage only, voltage waveform. So run simulation. After that VLDC, I will add over here, I will select it and okay. So this is showing the voltage waveform. So this is one. Now what we have to do is I'm going on run simulation, simulate run simulation, and I will select all the components, all the parameters over there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the calculation. So to do the calculation, first of all I'll do the calculation for average value. So this is average value, it is showing. Now for ILDC these are the different readings, and for VLDC these are the different readings. So what we have to do is I'm going to take this, just we'll do it again, like analysis. I will go on RMS suppose. So send to calculator, I will choose this, and if I'll say okay, so the reading it is showing is minus 0.0584166. If I'll take this parameter on calculator, I'll select it equal to, so it is 13.5657. Now for voltage, whatever the reading I want to see for voltage, if I want to see, then I will take this to calculator. I will select over here equal to, so it is 135.073. This is the value of DC output voltage. Now the current DC output current we got was 13.50. So how we can check? Current is voltage upon resistance. Resistance is 10 ohm. So if 135.073, this voltage which we are getting over here, if I divide that by 10, so I will be getting the current as 13.507, and the same thing we were getting over there. Just we saw that. Again, I will do the calculation to just, we will see if we are doing the calculation separately, then what happens? Means is it getting more easier to do the calculation or little bit complicated? Suppose I want to do the calculation for current. So for current, now what I'm going to do is measure. This is if I have to analyze the average value of this current. So average value is this one. So send to calculator, what is this value? So to see that, I'll click over here, I'll go on OK. So it is 14.6762 is the average value of current. Similarly, what is the RMS value of current? RMS value of current is, I'll take this reading on send to calculator. How we have to go? We have to right click on that. So here send to calculator, then I will select this, I'll say OK. So it is 16.7444. So this is RMS value of the output current, and this is average value. So average value which we got was 14.67. Now what we have to do is again I will run, and this time we will see only the output voltage. So if I'll select output voltage, then add OK. Now analysis. So this is average value of the voltage. So what is that? I'll take this on calculator, select this, it should be 146.76. that is correct. Why? Because if this voltage get divided by resistance, so how much we will get? We will get 14.67. yes. And what is the RMS value of output voltage? Send to calculator. So RMS value is 167.44. in this way we can calculate the average and output voltage of any circuit. In this case we have done the calculation for half wave controlled rectifier for resistive load. And to do the verification, we have the formula also, that is Vm upon 2 pi 1 plus cos alpha. So we have triggered this at 30 degrees. So if we substitute the value of 30, so we can get VLDC, and similarly we can find out ILDC also, and then VRMS and IRMS. So that will be our theoretical reading. This is our practical reading. Thank you.